Link TV, connecting you to the world. Link TV is viewer supported. Watch more at linktv.org.
Link TV presents Mosaic World News from the Middle East. Here are today's top stories.
Iran rejects new UN sanctions. Taliban bomber blamed for Afghan wedding carnage. And Obama announces $400 million in additional Palestinian aid. Mosaic World News from the Middle East begins now.
Hours after Tehran blamed Beijing for its support of the new international sanctions on Iran, Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad arrived in Shanghai. Ahmadinejad, who downplayed the significance of the sanctions, vowed to move forward with his country's nuclear program.
In another development, British Foreign Minister William Hague said that the European Union must study additional measures for the sanctions on Iran. Meanwhile, Russia announced that it has suspended an arms deal to sell S-300 missiles to Iran.
Not only did senior Iranian officials condemn the new UN Security Council sanctions on Iran, they also downplayed their significance. During a visit to Tajikistan, Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad did not seem bothered by the new sanctions.
Those who possess atomic bombs pass resolutions against us. My message to them, these sanctions are like a used handkerchief that should be tossed in the trash bin.
Iranian Foreign Minister Manoushehr Motaki said in a statement that the UN Security Council has harmed its image by approving the sanctions on Iran. A senior member of the Iranian Shura Council said that members of the council will review Tehran's cooperation with the International Atomic Energy Agency, the IAEA. At the international level, positions fluctuated between support of and opposition to the new sanctions on Iran. The Turkish Prime Minister described the sanctions as a mistake, vowing that his country, along with Brazil, will continue to search for a diplomatic solution to the crisis.
We and Brazil will do everything in our capacity to continue the dialogue with Iran. We will continue to exert efforts to keep the Tehran Agreement on the table, because world affairs should be achieved through diplomatic means.
The Venezuelan president criticized the U.S. and asked about imposing similar sanctions on Israel, which possesses nuclear weapons.
Why aren't any sanctions being imposed on Israel? You can see the mockery of the U.S. empire and its allies. Israel kills and slaughters, carries out incursions, and does not comply with U.N. resolutions, yet no one is holding it accountable.
On the other side of the aisle, U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton said that the sanctions will affect what she described as the Iranian nuclear ambitions. Clinton expressed hope over the possibility that Turkey and Brazil will continue their diplomatic efforts with Tehran. The position in Tel Aviv was more rigid, as Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu not only praised the new sanctions and described them as a positive step, but also called for imposing additional measures against the Iranian nuclear sector. Russia, which has long adopted a positive position towards Tehran, made a surprising announcement today by saying that it has suspended an arms deal to sell Iran S-300 missiles. China, an Iranian ally, approved the sanctions. A Chinese foreign ministry spokesman reassured the Iranians about their friendship with China, saying that the objective of the sanctions is to bring Tehran back to the bargaining table and not to close the door on the negotiations, a reassurance that the Iranians may briefly consider in light of this latest Chinese position.
Top story. Israel has come under fire at a meeting of the UN Atomic Agency. Arab and non-aligned states have called on Tel Aviv to come clean about its nuclear capability and open up to international inspections. It's the first time in two decades that the International Atomic Energy Agency has placed Israeli nuclear arms on its agenda. Israel has the only nuclear weapons arsenal in the Middle East. Tel Aviv is believed to have up to 300 atomic warheads. Arab countries told the meeting that Israel is a nuclear threat to regional peace and security. However, the European Union and the U.S. were reluctant to see Israel in the spotlight. Press TV's Eva Manasieva says they refused to engage in any discussions on the issue. She was at the IAEA headquarters keeping an eye on all the developments there.
The European Union refused at all to refer to the issue of Israel and the Israeli nuclear capabilities. They just ignored that topic absolutely, according to the Arab group. The U.S. statement, of course, was very much pro-Israeli oriented. The U.S. ambassador in his statement to the board said that it would be incorrect and inappropriate to single out Israel and to censor Israel in this relation. The Arab group and the Islamic nations called those comments outrageous. I already spoke with Egypt's ambassador to the IAEA. He was also speaking on behalf of the non-aligned movement. And if I have to quote him here, if North Korea and Iran are discussed in this boardroom here at IAEA, then Israel must also be discussed.
Well, Turkey's prime minister says the fresh UN Security Council sanctions on Iran are a mistake. Recep Tayyip Erdogan insists that Iran, Brazil and Turkey's nuclear fuel swap declaration was a diplomatic victory.
What happened in Tehran was a diplomatic success, and when we called them, they told us what you achieved is considered a diplomatic victory, which we congratulate you for. Why did they say no? Why are you in such a hurry? But until now, Iran has committed to its pledges. We do not want our partners to make similar mistakes, because history won't forgive us. The future generations won't forgive us.
Erdogan made the comments at a summit of Turkish and Arab ministers in Istanbul. He also once again stressed that negotiations are the best solution to solve the nuclear dispute between Iran and the West. Erdogan said Ankara will continue its diplomatic efforts to resolve those differences.
Strong condemnation. That's how the fourth round of sanctions against Iran have been met by Iranian officials.
Those countries that have atomic weapons and used them in the past are threatening others with those weapons. Those countries are issuing resolutions against us under the pretext that maybe we will make an atomic bomb in the future. But they should know that their resolution is not worth a penny to the Iranian nation.
When we come to the nuclear issue, What they have to say? What was wrong by Iran?
And people in Iran also denounce the sanctions and believe they won't be able to stop their country from moving forward.
Sanctions will not affect us whatsoever. So far they have passed fourth round of sanctions.
Our progression is increasing day to day. Our nuclear scientists are continuing their activities, and God willing, they will move forward in all fields. I don't think that sanctions will affect us.
There has been a plethora of reactions to the sanctions against Iran around the world. Brazil's President Lula da Silva has criticized the approval of the resolution as a mistake. And Venezuelan President Hugo Chavez has condemned the Security Council resolution in the strongest possible words.
Why doesn't the Security Council sanction Israel? You realize the cynicism of the U.S. and its allies in the world? Israel massacres and murders don't fulfill United Nations resolutions.
But the sanctions have been received differently by the U.S. and its allies, including Israel.
We were very pleased by the action in the Security Council. These were the most significant sanctions that have been imposed.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has welcomed the sanctions, and he has called on all countries to act on the sanctions, including those targeting Iran's energy sector. But many analysts and political leaders believe that the sanctions will have no effect on Iran's progress, since the country has already been subject to U.S.-sponsored sanctions for decades. They believe diplomacy is the best way forward.
Iran's parliament plans to consider a bill to review Tehran's ties with the IAEA, the UN Atomic Agency. The move comes after the fresh round of UN sanctions against Tehran. The The deputy head of the Iranian Parliament's Foreign Policy Committee, Ismail Kosari, says MPs will put the legislation to vote on Sunday. Kosari described the three Western veto-holding members of the UN Security Council as bullying states. Kosari also said the anti-Iranian resolution is aimed at distracting world public opinion from the Israeli attack on the Gaza aid flotilla. He added that the Iranian people view the new sanctions as illegal.
Today marks the first anniversary of the Iranian elections, which were accompanied by protests and the detention of members of the opposition. On this occasion, we will present a series of reports about Iran. The following report talks about the future of the Green Movement 1 year after it was launched on the Iranian street. We'll leave you with a report by Hali Adel from Tehran.
The Iranian reformist movement, or what is known as the Green Movement, was born under tough conditions 1 year ago. The movement went through a difficult period of time because its leaders were divided and had different political platforms and positions, which prevented the opposition from being effective. This resulted in the decrease of popularity of the Green Movement's leaders, even among the Iranians who are opposed to Ahmadinejad's policies. However, political observers believe that the Green Movement is still alive.
The Green Movement, which is the symbol of the opposition, is still present. In any democratic country, it is normal to have an opposition. In this case, we can call it an internal opposition.
Opposition leaders are trying to reform things at a very slow pace, although they were declared as enemies of the regime, which described the Green Movement as the Velvet Revolution because it was contained in certain areas of the country.
Although demonstrations are still taking place on the street, the Green Movement continues to make sure that the law in Iran is not violated. It does not want to change the government, which has become a reality. The Green Movement has already stipulated its position towards the Islamic Republic.
Although the reasons for the election crisis remain unchanged, and although some constitutional articles were violated, not to mention the presidential elections, which were rigged according to the opposition, the Iranian people are about to stop supporting the reformists because they are divided and have agreed to revert to the old political status quo. Hali Adel, Future TV, Tehran.
More than 40 people were killed and 80 others were injured in a suicide attack that targeted a wedding party in southern Afghanistan. Police said that most of the people in attendance were linked to the police and some militias in northern Kandahar. This comes as General Stanley McChrystal, the commander of NATO forces in Afghanistan, said that the military operation in Kandahar will slow down and will last at least until next fall.
For a few seconds, he thought that the world was coming to an end. This was the impression of one of the guests who was attending a wedding in southern Afghanistan that was the target of a suicide attack. The bodies of dozens of people were scattered everywhere and smoke hovered above the newlyweds. The location used to celebrate the wedding party was full of blood.
Based on what I saw, 150 to 160 people were killed or injured.
The police said that the guests have links to security officers and some militias. Police said that this is why the Taliban targeted this kind of gathering. However, the Taliban denied responsibility for the attack. The attacker blew himself up amidst 400 guests in northern Kandahar's Argandab district, where American and Afghan forces launched the largest military operation since the invasion of Afghanistan in 2001. Meanwhile, there are ongoing NATO preparations for the attack that were announced by the American forces. Intensive Canadian patrol units were inspecting some of the areas in the region.
دوريات وحواجز مكثفة سيرها الجنود الكنديون
When the Canadian soldiers pass through here, we stay inside our homes. When they are subjected to attacks by the Taliban, they arrest and interrogate us. It's very difficult and dangerous here, and we can't tend to our farms.
وكانت قوات التحالف تجري عملية سحب 2800 من
NATO forces replaced 2,800 Canadian soldiers with British soldiers. This will create a controversy in Britain, which has the second largest number of forces in Afghanistan after the US. Hussein Shahada, Al Arabiya.
بعد أسبوع على الهجوم الإسرائيلي الدموي على قافلة الحرية، واشنطن تسعى لاحتواء تداعيات الهجوم.
One week after the bloody Israeli attack on the Freedom Flotilla, Washington is trying to contain the repercussions of the attack and resume the peace talks. President Obama received President Mahmoud Abbas in the White House. He described the situation in Gaza as unbearable. The American president vowed to send $400 million in economic aid to the Palestinians. Obama said that major progress can be achieved in the Middle East peace process before the end of the year, despite the Israeli attack on the Freedom Flotilla. He reiterated that the U.S. will use all of its influence to push the peace process forward and end the deadlock.
أما تداعيات الهجوم الإسرائيلي على أسطول الحرية لا تزال حاضرة في الشارع الكوري الجنوبي حيث تظهر
Meanwhile, the Israeli attack on the Freedom Flotilla is still generating reactions in South Korea. Dozens of activists demonstrated against the visit of Israeli President Shimon Peres. They held signs condemning Israeli practices against the Palestinians as well as the Turkish activists who were on board the Freedom Flotilla. The demonstrations dominated the visit of the Israeli president, who held talks with South Korean President Lee Myung in Seoul today.
ونبقى في كوريا الجنوبية حيث أفادت محطة تلفزيون
In other news, Radio YTN said that South Korea launched a missile carrying a satellite for research purposes, but that it had exploded 2 minutes after its launch. This is South Korea's second failed attempt to deliver a satellite into orbit.
في موضوع آخر سمحت إسرائيل بعبور كميات من البضائع والمواد الغذائية عبر
Israel has allowed the entry of some previously banned goods and food items to the Gaza Strip via the Karam al-Salem border crossing. The measure will allow Israel to transport a large part of the goods which Palestinians used to smuggle through tunnels from Egypt to the Gaza Strip.
من مصر إلى قطاع غزة
Over the last year
Israel has increased the quantity and expanded the variety of goods entering the Gaza Strip. This has been and will continue to be our policy.
ونعود مرة أخرى ونذكر بقضية المساعدات التي سمحت إسرائيل بإدخالها إلى قطاع غزة ومعنا من هناك مراسل بي بي سي
Joining us for Gaza is our BBC correspondent Shukri Al-Kashif. Can you provide information on the nature of the aid being allowed into Gaza via the Karam Abu Salem border crossing in terms of the quantity and type of goods?
والكمية التي عبرت من معبر كرم أبو سالم
يعني للتوضيح فإن أكثر من 4,200 صنف تمنع إسرائيل إدخالها منذ
Since the Israeli blockade on Gaza went into effect, more than 4,200 products have been banned from entering Gaza. According to the Israeli list of banned items, only 115 products, more than 33 of which are agricultural products, are being allowed into the Gaza Strip. What happened today was an expansion of the list of items allowed entry into the Gaza Strip. Some of the items that were removed from the list of banned products are soft drinks, juices, salads of all types, biscuits and chips, mostly for the consumption of children. It's a new expanded list that was authorized by the Israeli authorities. The new measure will go into effect early next week. However, we still can't confirm that the new aid will reach the Gaza Strip. Most of the residents in Gaza don't think much of it. Most of the goods that are being allowed in Gaza are complementary and not essential items.
Shukri, the new measure to allow certain food items into Gaza, was it a one-time thing or was it a complete lift of the ban? Now that the ban is lifted, will these items be allowed into Gaza on a regular basis?
هذه المواد ستشملها قضية توسيع لائحة ما.
These items were removed from the list of banned products. They will likely be allowed into Gaza on a regular basis, provided, of course, that they are allowed by the Hamas-led government of Gaza. It's obvious that the Hamas movement and its government in Gaza are not happy with this latest Israeli measure.
لهذه الخطوة الإسرائيلية مرد ذلك وفقا لبيان من وزارة الاقتصاد.
The Ministry of Economy in Gaza issued a statement saying that it is trying to protect the welfare of Palestinian products. More than three or four soft drink companies operate in the Gaza Strip, but they have been shut down due to the Israeli ban on raw materials. Hamas is demanding that Israel allow the entry of raw materials, which can be used to restart some of the factories that have ceased operation due to the blockade on the Gaza Strip. However, some think that Hamas opposes the measure in order to maintain the status quo, which has been tense since the Israeli attack on the Freedom Flotilla.
Thank you, Shukri, for your insight and clarification.
The Iraqi Kurdistan Parliament held a special session on Tuesday to discuss the implications of the Iranian cross-border shelling. The parliament called on Iraqi President Jalal Talabani, the federal government, the UN, and the international community to clarify their respective positions on the shelling of the Kurdish border territory.
The Kurdistan Parliament held an extra session on Tuesday to discuss the ongoing Iranian artillery attack and shelling of the Kurdish border territory. The Internal Committee of the Kurdistan Parliament visited the battered areas and assessed the level of damage there. The committee condemned the ongoing Iranian artillery shelling of Kurdish border areas.
وفي تقرير قدمته هذه اللجنة أوردت الأضرار والخسائر التي تعرضت.
More than 200 families have been displaced by the bombardment, which also caused the destruction of crops in the region, especially in the areas of Hajumran, Waziristan, Zukan, and Razga.
وبالأخص في مناطق حاج عمران وسيدكان وزيوكان ورزقة.
In addition, a 15-year-old girl was martyred and a woman sustained serious injuries in the shelling. Members of the Kurdistan Parliament unanimously condemned the military operations launched by the Iranian forces. The Iranian forces also carried out an incursion by deploying ground troops about 3 kilometers deep into Iraqi territory and the Kurdistan region. Kurdish MPs called on Iran to compensate the displaced families and resolve the crisis through dialogue and diplomatic means. They also called for resolving the border issues with neighboring Iran. Kamran Mohammed, Iraqiya, Erbil.
Iraqi security agencies in the province of Nineveh arrested a terror suspect who was strapped with an explosive belt minutes before blowing himself up in an area west of Mosul.
He was arrested in a security operation in the area of Talia, north of the province. There were no reports of clashes.
The 10th Brigade of the Iraqi Army's 3rd Infantry Division carried out a successful security operation in Nineveh province, capturing would-be suicide bomber Faisal Ahmad. Ahmad was about to blow himself up in a busy neighborhood in the area of Talia, north of Nineveh. In a statement issued to the Iraqiya Channel, commander of the 10th Brigade, Major General Abdel Rahman Hantal, talked about the capturing of the terrorist.
We tracked down a terrorist who was strapped with an explosive belt and was about to blow himself up in a busy neighborhood in the area of Talia in the county of Talafar. We have been following him for several days. Last night, the would-be suicide bomber arrived in the county of Talafar, where a security team was waiting for him. He was arrested and the explosive belt was dismantled.
Through the Iraqi army's successful security operation and the cooperation of the people of Talafar, the army has once again proven its capability to counter terror. Iraqiya Channel, Riyad Al-Salam, Talafar.
من جهة أخرى استشهد أربعة مواطنين وأصيب خمسة.
In another development, four people were martyred and five others were wounded in a motorcycle bomb attack launched by a terrorist north of the city of Bakuba. A security source said that the terrorist detonated his booby-trap motorcycle this afternoon on the main street in the area of Aruba, in the center of Migdadiya County. The bomber targeted a private vehicle carrying several members of the county's tribal support council.
She weighs 600 pounds and counting and has set a target of reaching 1,000 pounds. Donna Simpson is already the fattest woman in the United States and doesn't mind it. In fact, she believes bigger is beautiful. We get more, much more, in this Reuters report.
She weighs a staggering 600 pounds, but for New Jersey mother Donna Simpson, being even bigger is even more beautiful. The 42-year-old, who has battled with her weight since childhood, has decided enough is not enough and has set herself a personal goal to reach 1,000 pounds, making her the world's fattest woman.
And I just said, you know what, I wouldn't mind being bigger. I really wouldn't mind being bigger. And so just slowly I thought, oh, I wonder what it would be like to be, you know, 700 pounds. And I wonder what it would be like to be 800 pounds. You know, I wonder what I would look like that. And I said, you know what, I wouldn't mind being 1,000 pounds.
To get there, Donna has been consuming up to 12,000 calories a day, with her grocery bill costing up to $750 a week. She says her favorite foods are chocolate and sushi.
One time I ate 70 pieces of sushi. I know, I guess like the normal is like 9 pieces or something. Everybody's like, I can eat 9 or 10. I'm like, okay. I'd be very mad if somebody put 9 pieces of sushi in front of me. I'd be like,
Philip Gwamba says he supports his partner's goal, although the couple agrees they wouldn't want the children to follow in their mother's footsteps. Donna admits she's received death threats from people outraged about her goal. Even so, she isn't fearing for her life or her health.
People always ask me, I'm afraid to die because of my weight and things like that. I believe that our time is set. It's predestined. So I believe that if something's going to happen, I can't stop it.
As for the future, the pair hope to marry. Philip says although he hasn't set a date, he's already picked a location.
It will be at the top of Mount Haleakala, Hawaii, on the island of Maui. And I want it to be sunrise wedding, 6 a.m. or so, new day, new beginning, fresh start on the top of the world.
Donna says she wants her own reality television series to show that a woman of size can have a regular family.
The views expressed on Mosaic are from contributing broadcasters, not Link TV or its sponsors. The production of Mosaic is made possible from support of viewers like you. Thank you. Watch Mosaic World News online, stay up to date with breaking news, read our blog, get transcripts of past shows and more at linktv.org/mosaic.
This program is brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. network dedicated to global and national news, uncompromising documentaries, and diverse cultural programs, programs which connect you to the world.